Alright, hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Emily and I am on a fitness journey. That's about it. So, diving right into today's video, we are doing a Built Bar review. So, Amazon has a variety pack of Built Bars available and I had seen ads for these everywhere. I'd seen what felt like everybody eating them and I was like, I've never heard of these. What's going on? So my Safeway does not carry them, hence the Amazon order, but I've seen them most other places and I was really interested. So this variety pack comes with 12 different flavors. Two of the flavors repeat themselves. It's coconut and mint brownie. So they're in both the Built Bar and the Built Bar Puff, which I feel like the only difference between a regular Built Bar and a Built Bar Puff is it's kind of like more marshmallowy, a little bit lighter, I think, like in texture. The first one that I tried, I'll put pictures of them up here, and then I'll link the variety pack in the description just in case you want to try a little sample. First one I tried was a raspberry flavor, and this one I gave a 9 out of 10. It's a really good raspberry flavor. It literally tastes like a chocolate-covered raspberry, even like freezer-dried. Winco used to have like chocolate-covered freeze-dried strawberries. It reminds me of that, but with raspberry, and it's so good. I love the texture of these bars. I don't love the Built Bar Puffs as much, but it's like the same texture as like a caramelly chocolate bar, almost like a more dense Milky Way, kind of like in between a Milky Way and a Snickers. I did dock one point because this flavor has kind of a weird aftertaste. I can't really place it. It's just not my favorite thing, but I've eaten it twice and I would buy it again. The cookies and cream flavor, 10 out of 10. It's perfect for a sweet craving. All of these bars have really good macros in them. They're fairly low calorie for a good amount of protein. They're like between 140 to 180 calories per bar. And they're, I think, between, 17 to 18 or 19 grams of protein. Don't hold me to that. They fit really nicely if I want a snack. They fit great in my macros. Perfect for a sweet craving. Absolutely would eat again, have eaten again, would purchase again, all that kind of stuff. There's a few of these that are very much like protein chocolate bars. This is one of them, double chocolate. I gave it a 10 out of 10. I have a huge sweet tooth. Recently, I've been able to get it a little bit more in check because I have been eating higher protein. I've been focusing on my macros instead of just calories and stuff. So because I've been focusing more on especially vegetables, fruits, protein, and all the fiber and stuff that comes with that, I feel like I am fuller longer. I'm not craving quite as many sweets as I used to. I'll have a few days where it's like I can't get enough, but I used to have that multiple times a week and now it's like twice a month. So yeah, I feel like the double chocolate is a really good substitute for a candy bar. So like if you're just on your fitness journey, you don't want to eliminate anything, which I advise against anyways, you want to kind of substitute. I think this is a great option. So the coconut and the coconut puff, I love these, but one of my favorite candy bars are like Mounds and Almond Joys. I love them. The only thing I don't love about some of these bars is they really stick to your teeth, and I have permanent retainers on my top and bottom. That's not my favorite part. So I did dock it one for that. So both of these get a 9 out of 10. They're just a little more caramely than I would like. And it's just, I'm like sitting there like trying to get it off of my teeth. But it really, these taste like a Mounds or an Almond Joy. They taste so good. I love them. I'm really excited to get this variety pack back in. So excited. But anyways, the next one is a Cherry Garcia. I am not a cherry fan. So I'm always hesitant going towards anything fruit punch, cherry flavored, anything like that. This one's actually pretty good. I rated it a 7 out of 10 for me. I feel like if you like cherry flavors, it'll probably be closer to an 8 or a 9 or a 10. It has a really good chocolate flavor. I feel like they did a good job balancing it. It's not overly cherry. It's not overly chocolate. It's a really good bar. So there is a churro flavor. I was really excited about this and I was a little bit disappointed. I don't really know what I was expecting. It's more of just a cinnamon flavored bar than I would say a churro. Like I feel like I get kind of a cinnamon roll vibe as well as a churro vibe. And I feel like I would have rather it have been marketed as a cinnamon roll. I think because churros, you're really expecting that crunch on the outside, and that's not what these bars are. They're not crunchy. their softer bar. And I was just like, it's a cinnamon flavored bar. It's not a churro. It's a cinnamon flavored bar. So like, I understood where they were going with it. It just, I was a little bit disappointed by what they named it. So I feel like a cinnamon roll would have been a better option. Still super tasty. I still really look forward to eating it every time I get the variety pack. I have not yet committed to a full 12 pack of any of these flavors. I've bought the variety pack now 3 times. The next one is called Brownie Batter. And my inner fat kid was so excited. I literally, when I was younger, could have eaten an entire bowl of just batter for brownies, anything. 100%. So I was really excited. 10 out of 10, absolutely delicious. Another great substitute for if you are having a really, really tough time with sweets and you really want something that's going to fit into your macros a little bit better. I think this is such a good option. Again, I always recommend trying one before buying an entire pack. That's just me. The next one is peanut butter brownie. So I'm a little bit strange in a lot of ways, but with this, I love like Reese's cups and I like the Justin's peanut butter cups and I like peanut butter in general. I don't like peanut butter flavored things typically. This one wasn't my favorite. It was in a 7 out of 10. I don't mind the texture. I would not buy a case of just these. I would be very disappointed in myself if I did that. But I mean, I think if you liked peanut butter, you might like it a little bit better than I did. It's just, it's peanut butter flavored things is not, but I don't gravitate towards those at all. I've had a handful that I really enjoy, probably less than a handful of peanut butter flavored things I really enjoy that again, aren't like Ritz crackers. So aren't like the Ritz peanut butter crackers. Still good. Honestly, I was not disappointed in any of these flavors. There's 3 left. I'm going to do, there's mint brownie and a mint brownie puff. I wish the mint flavor was a little bit stronger in these. I feel like that's a disappointment I have a lot, is I really like the mint flavor and I love mint chocolate things. Like, but I love their chocolate flavor. Their chocolate flavor is amazing. I would still eat these. I would buy a pack of these and be happy. I wouldn't be upset if I accidentally ordered a full pack of the either the puffs or the regular. It's just, I want more oomph. I want more mint. And that's probably just me. So I gave it an 8 out of 10 for both. If I had put more mint, it would probably be like 9.5 out of 10, but whatever. So last one is the salted caramel. And anyone that knows me will tell you, I freaking love caramel and caramel flavored things. But 10 out of 10, I would buy a whole case of these. And I would probably, if I didn't control myself, go through it very quickly. Once I have something in the house and I know I like it, I eat it immediately. So with these Built Bars, I try to limit myself to one a day because personally, I'm trying to get my protein goal from whole food sources anyways, not necessarily from like supplements and protein bars. That's just me. I do whatever works for you. That is my Built Bar review. I really wish I was sponsored by them because I would be the happiest little camper in the entire world. But One day I'll be sponsored by Built Bar. Yeah, so that is my video. Kind of a more lighthearted, fun one. I've got more planned. I have a lot of plans for this channel. I have more updates soon. I'm super excited. I have personal updates I'm excited to share. Yeah, so if you found this video interesting, please leave a like or a nice comment. I like the nice ones. If you are feeling generous, if you could subscribe to my channel, I would be so happy. I'm really trying to hit 500 subscribers by June. It is currently May 18th, and I am dying over here to try and hit that number. I've had numbers for all my socials. My Instagram is only, I think, 13 followers away from my goal of 300. My Facebook just surpassed mine. It was 200. I have the links to my socials below. If you're not following either of them, please, please do. Make me so happy. But yeah, I hope you guys have an amazing day. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye!